Section 10 of the Topaz Storybook. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. Recording by Nan Dodge. The Topaz Storybook, Stories and Legends of Autumn, Halloween, and Thanksgiving. The Shet-Up Posy. Once there was a posy. 'Twasn't a common kind of posy that blows out wide open, so's everybody can see its outsides and its insides, too, but 'twas one of them posies like what grows down the road back of your pa's sugar house, Danny, and don't come till way towards fall. They're sort of blue, but real dark, and they looks if they was buds instead of posies, only buds opens out and these doesn't. They're all shut up close and tight, and they never, never, never opens. Never mind how much sun they get, never mind how much rain or how much drouth, whether it's cold or hot, them posies stay shut up tight, kind of buddy, and not finished and humly. But if you pick 'em open real careful with a pin, I've done it, you find they're dreadful pretty inside. You couldn't see a posy that was finished off better, soft and nice, with pretty little stripes painted on 'em, and all the little things like threads in the middle, such as the open posies has, standing up with little knots on their tops. Oh, so pretty. You never did. Makes you think real hard, that does. Leastwise makes me. What's they that way for? If they ain't never going to open out, what's the use of having the shet-up part so slicked up and nice, with nobody never seeing it? Folks has different names for 'em. Dumb foxgloves, blind gentians, and all that, but I allers call 'em the shet-up posies. Well, 'twas one of that kind of posy I was going to tell you about. 'Twas one of the shet-uppest and the buddiest of all on 'em, so blacky blue and straight up and down, and shet-up fast and tight. Nobody'd ever dreamt it was pretty inside, and the funniest thing, it didn't know 'twas so itself. It thought 'twas a mistake somehow. Thought it had oughta been a posy, and was begun for one, but wasn't finished, and 'twas terrible unhappy. It knew there was pretty posies all round there, goldenrod and purple daisies and all, and their inside was the right side, and they was proud of it, and held it open, and showed the pretty lining all soft and nice, with the little fuzzy yeller threads standin' up, with little balls on their tip ends, and the shet-up posy felt real bad. Not mean and hateful and begrudgin', you know, but wantin' to take away the nice part from the other posies, but sorry, and kind of shamed. Oh, deary me, she says, I most forgot to say, 'twas a girl posy. Deary me, what a humly, skimpy, awkward thing I be. I ain't more than half made, there ain't no nice pretty linin' inside of me, like them other posies, and only my wrong side shows, and that's just plain and common. Can't chirk up folks like the goldenrod and daisies does. Nobody won't want to pick me and carry me home. I ain't no good to nobody, and I never shall be. So she kept on thinking these dreadful sorry thinkins, and most wishin' she'd never been made at all. You know, 'twasn't just at first she felt this way. First she thought she was a bud, like lots of buds all round her, and she lotted on openin' like they did. But when the days kept passin' by, and all the other buds opened out and showed how pretty they was, and she didn't open, why, then she got terrible discouraged, and I don't wonder a mite. She'd see the dew a-layin' soft and cool on the other posies' faces, and the sun a-shinin' warm on 'em as they held 'em up, and sometimes she'd see a butterfly come down and light on 'em real soft, and kind of put his head down to 'em as he was kissin' 'em, and she thought 'twould be powerful nice to hold her face up to all them pleasant things, but she couldn't. But one day, afore she'd got very old, afore she'd dried up or fell off or anything like that, she see somebody coming along her way. 'Twas a man, and he was looking at all the posies real hard and particular, but he wasn't picking any of 'em. Seems if he was looking for something different from what he see, and the poor little shet-up posy began to wonder what he was after. Blimey, she braced up and asked him about it in her shet-up whisperin' voice, and says he, the man says, "I'm a-pickin' posies. That's what I work at most of the time. 'Tain't for myself," he says, but the one I work for. I'm only his help. I run errands and do chores for him, and it's a particular kind of posy he's sent me for today." "What for does he want 'em?" says the shut-up posy. "Why, to set out in his garden," the man says. "He's got the beautifulest garden you never see, and I pick posies for it." "Deary me," thinks she to herself, "I just wish he'd pick me. But I ain't the kind, I know." And then she says, so soft he can't hardly hear her, "What sort of posies is it you're arter this time?" "Well," says the man, "it's a dreadful singler order I got today. I got to find a posy that's handsomer inside than 'tis outside. One that folks ain't took no notice of here, 'cause 'twas kind o' humly and queer to look at, not knowin' that inside 'twas as handsome as any posy on the earth." "Seen any of that kind?" says the man. Well, the shut-up posy was dreadful worked up. "Deary, dear," she says to herself. "Now, if they'd only finished me off inside, I'm the right kind outside, humly and queer enough. But there's nothing worth looking at inside, I'm sure of that." But she didn't say this nor anything else out loud, and bimeby, when the man had waited and didn't get any answer, he began to look at the shut-up posy more particular to see why she was so mum. And all of a sudden, he says, the man did, "Looks to me as if you was something that kind yourself, ain't ye?" "Oh, no, no, no," whispers the shut-up posy. "I wish I was, I wish I was. I'm all right outside, humly and awkward, queer as I can be. But I ain't pretty inside. Oh, I most know I ain't. I ain't so sure of that myself," says the man, "but I can tell in a jiffy." "Will you have to pick me to pieces?" says the shut-up posy. "No, ma'am," says the man. "I got a way of tellin'. The one I work for showed me." The shut-up posy never knowed what he'd done to her. I don't know myself, but 'twas something soft and pleasant that didn't hurt a mite. And then the man, he says, "Well, well, well." That's all he said. But he took her up, real gentle, and begun to carry her away. "Where be ye takin' me?" says the shut-up posy. "Where ye belong," says the man. "To the garden of the one I work for," he says. "I didn't know I was nice enough inside," says the shut-up posy very soft and still. "They most generally don't," says the man. End of section 10.